Good morning. It's a wonderful day out there. It's hot, 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 and I'm glad I'm inside here in the butcher shop where it's nice and cool. I don't do very well in the heat. So today this video is all about beef yield. I just came off the phone with a farmer who wanted to know if he slaughters a steer for himself, how much meat he would get. And so I thought it would be a great video to make a video about, to explain, because it's a question I get quite often. How much meat do I get back from a beef, from a pig, from a lamb, or whatever? And as a hunter, I'm also a bit dabbling in hunting forums and these online messaging centers. And I hear a lot of hunters always complain, I got such and such animal in, a buck, a moose, an elk, whatever, and it weighed so and so much, and I only got so and so much meat back home. And it's a common conception a lot of people have. They see a nice steer in the field, or a nice elk, or a deer, or whatever, and they say, oh, I get a lot of meat out of that. To make a long story very short, but I'm going to explain it to you more carefully just in a minute. What you see in the field is not edible, not all of it. If your meat cutter is very good and you treat the animal right, you will get about between 60 and in a very good case 70% of that animal back to eat. The rest is waste. And for hunters it's sometimes even bigger, the loss. Depends how you shoot the animal, where you shoot it, how long it took for the animal to go down before it died. The loss can be almost 50%. Yeah, because so we're going to explain that all to you. And I hope after that explanation you understand what you get back and what's involved. So without further ado, I wrote a list down here, and we're gonna look together at that list, and I'm explaining as I go on where all the weights are listed and what you can expect. So here we go, just let me adjust the camera. So here we are. I hope you can see that all. I made it as good as I could. So it's beef yield. And what I done is I took the weight of an average slaughter steer. Steer life weight, 1,500 pounds. Of course, that's not the meat you get back. That's the live animal as you see it on the pasture or in the barn. Then the animal has to be slaughtered, and then what we end up after it is slaughtered and hanging on the hook is dressed carcass weight. The dressed carcass weight is give or take 715 pounds. So you see it's a drastic drop from that weight to that weight. It's not quite, but a little bit over a third. So why does it lose so much weight? The weight loss is 780 pounds that you can't eat. The blood, when we bleed the animal, there's quite a considerable weight. I don't know the weight conversion, but it's a grown steer about that weight has about 30 liters of blood in them. And if we say a liter is 1 kilo, I don't know how much that is in pound. Here in Canada we are metric, but we still use pounds for live and dead animals. So it's about 25 to 30 kilos of blood. The head alone, when we cut the head off, can weigh up to 30 kilos. The skin can weigh over 100 kilos. the digestive tract, that's the rumen, small and large intestines and the colon, they can weigh up to 200 pounds and more. Depends if the farmer fed the animal before it got slaughtered and he weighed it, then it will be even heavier. If the animal is 24 hours fasted before it gets killed, the weight will be a little bit less. Then we have internal organs like liver, lung, heart, and so forth. Kidney fat, and so that's all inedible. Well, some people, they do eat the tripe, and they do eat internal organs such as liver, heart, and they take the kidney fat to render it into tallow for cooking and whatever. But still, it's considered inedible meat. It's considered waste. So these together make the loss to a weight of 780 pound from 1,500 pound. So now we have the dressed carcass. It is split, the carcass is split in half, is quartered and hangs in my cooler. And that's the dressed processing weight. It's 780 pounds, that's what we weighed when it came in. And then we start processing and cutting it into steaks and ground beef and sausages and roasts and whatever you want. So your take-home meat will now be, after it is processed, wrapped and frozen, will only be plus minus 569 pounds. That's the meat you take home to eat. The weight loss from the carcass weight 780 is 100, give or take 130.7 pounds. That too is a considerable weight. So what you end up finally with take home meat is give or take around 65, in a good case 70% of meat from the live weight. The weight loss comes due to bones. When we debone the animal, that they have a considerable weight too. They can weigh up to 50 pounds, all the bones together. Good, some cuts might have the bone in, if you like T-bone steaks or rib steaks and so forth, the bone is in, short ribs and so forth, there is the bone in it too. But they don't amount to much in weight. Then another weight loss is tendons and sinew. That too can be about 20, 25 kilos. Silver skin, that all get trimmed off. Excessive fat gets trimmed off, and all the gristle that's between the muscles. It's a fatty little substance and doesn't taste nice, so we cut that out. We also cut out all the glands and the big blood vessels. You don't want this in your sausages, you don't want this in your ground beef. I wouldn't eat it, neither should you. Sometimes also bloodshot meat, like where the animal has been bled and so, that's all bloodshot that goes in the garbage, or we grind it down for you to take home for dog food. And then other trim. There's always some other trim that has to be trimmed because it doesn't look nice. Now that weight is, that 130 pounds is if the animal has hang in our cooler for 1 week. The longer you hang an animal, the more weight you lose, and the less meat you get to take home. Because as the animal hangs and ages, as we say, and I always age on the carcass, not individual cuts, otherwise you would lose even more meat, more weight. The carcass dries out, the moisture gets out of it, and so the weight loss, with each week you age an animal, the weight loss gets bigger. Take-home meat is also heavily influenced by the condition the animal was in while it was still alive. Okay? For example, this is a nice steer, ready to be slaughtered, and is bred and fed to be slaughtered. It's a beef animal. Now, if you have a an older animal or a dairy cow or so, the loss will be even bigger here. Simply because the dairy cow or another meat-free animal that still is edible just doesn't have the muscle structure and the amount of muscle meat that a healthy, good fed and cared for steer has, because they eat a completely different food, that they might even get next to grass and hay, they might even get grain and so forth, because you want them to have a lot of meat on them and a good fat structure and good marbling in the meat. By a dairy cow or another animal that the farmer just decides to kill for himself, that's mostly not the case, so that the loss will be even bigger simply because of that. The muscle structure, the meat is not there. There's more bones than meat sometimes. It also depends on the age of an animal. A younger animal usually gets more take-home meat than an older animal for the same reason, because younger animals, they're fit, they run around, they build a lot of muscles, whereas older animals, they stand around and don't do much, and therefore the muscle disappears. So there's a lot of variables, but here in our store, we always, or not always, but most of the cases, we very rarely go under 60% of the take-home meat. And if I do, I actually will phone the client up and tell them, look, this and this. For example, last week I had one, it had a little abscess on the hind leg and so on. Of course, that has to be cut out and thrown away. You can't give that. And so that there was like almost 5 pounds of meat that was infected around the abscess that had to be cut out and thrown away. And then we tell them. So this is what it is. And the same with hunters, it's the same thing. You see a nice buck in a field, and he has, let's say, weighs 160 pounds. That's not the meat you get home. The same with a moose. A moose can be heavier than a steer. Yeah? That's not the meat you get home. When you see a live animal in the field or as a hunter in the woods, what you get home is only about by wild game, it might be even less, be only about 50% you get home, because you shot the animal in the chest, through the heart and so, and all that has to be trimmed out, so half of that meat is gone. That can be easily 20 pounds of meat that's bloodshot, that has to be removed. And so you get about between 50 and 55% of wild game meat home. By livestock, and there too it varies, that's not just a steer that I wrote down, for example. Pigs, it's a little bit higher, because a lot of people have bone-in roasts and so forth, and there is not so much trim as on a beef. And a sheep will yield very well, because there is basically no waste on a sheep. It's all cut up and there's very little waste on a beef, on a lamb, and neither on a pig, but on a beef there is considerable waste. So there you have it. That's the short and the long of it. And I need another sip of coffee. All that talking made me a little bit thirsty, and I have to go back to work now. And then thank you very much for watching this video, and like I said, I hope that it answers some questions you had yourself. And if you like our videos, if you like the information we provide here, please let other people know that might be interested too. And don't forget to hit this subscription button, so you're always updated when new videos are uploaded. I'm not capable of doing it weekly or bi-weekly. I think the last video I uploaded was about a month ago. It's simply because, not because I'm too lazy to do it, it's, without bragging, I'm a hard worker. I work 7 days a week, and so like now in between I make a video or so and upload it. And I don't just upload any video. I do want to provide proper information that helps the people who watch my channel. So thank you for watching, and God bless you all, and have a great day.